Many of us assume that we're doing fine when it comes to our foundational skills, but sometimes we develop unconscious strategies to avoid tasks that might be challenging or even a little scary. For example, we might avoid using computers.
Hi, I'm Patrick Lin. It's good. One more night of ACE, Introduction to Computer Course.
But as some of these students have discovered, computer skills open doors to new opportunities in the workplace.
I'm Naomi Chin. I'm married and I'm working in the health department. And I found that doing this computer course, I'm sure in the future it helps me in case I want to change my job and I'll be able to work.
Which text over here?
Yes. Just type. That's right. Yes. So type created, edited by. What I realized with these students is that when they first come for the course itself, they have a lot of phobia for the machine. And normally what I do is during the first lesson, instead of like going into a thing, I actually talk to them, chit-chat with them and find out if they have that fear. That should be the one, okay?
When I first started using the computer and I'm pretty nervous, you know, and it's like a different machine to me, you know.
If you have a message that comes through, just click OK.
Most important, I think, in this modern technology, you need to know emailing, because everybody asks me all the time, have you got an email address, you know? In this way, you can communicate through computer, you know, through email.
What we're going to do is that, first of all, we are going to create a header, and then after, we're going to create a footer.
I was too busy with working and with my children, you know, always busy as a mom doing housework and working, you know, and I found that now it's time for me to do something for myself.
Normie was one who is very fearful of the computer. She has seen her kids using a computer, and her son actually locked her out of the computer. So for Normie, customization of computer was actually excellent for her. That was when she actually learned that she could actually block other users from the computer instead of herself being blocked out of the computer itself.
I'm Linda Swarbrick and I've come to TAFE to do a course in computers. I was in retail for the last 25 years and I feel that I needed to broaden my horizons. My children have all grown up now in their teenage years and I needed to learn some new life skills. I wasn't exposed to computers.
For the case of Linda, she was pretty much at home doing some casual work, not much office space. I was actually quite surprised, presently surprised that she actually told me that she is now on a government job with the disability services. I thought she has made excellent progress. Go to insert tab, go to header, all right.
My children with schooling, I couldn't help them do their homework in particular because my 11-year-old daughter could do things that I couldn't do.
Page 2.
Yep. Click on the body. Nope. Go down a little bit below the dotted lines. Choose clip art.
Clip art, yeah.
Vertical scroll bar up.
Yeah, my name's Andrew England. I live in Kelmscott. I'm sort of retired at the moment. I used to work in the mines. I had to put in data, like hour meter readings, etc. And that's the sort of thing I'm looking to go and do on a permanent basis because I can't climb over machines anymore. Before I was hands-on, I was doing all the mechanical work and fueling up and greasing machines.
Andrew came in with some information about the computer, some skills about using a computer, but like what Andrew had mentioned, it was not a formal training. It was a lot of try and error.
Well, I'd played around with computers quite a lot. You know, internet and that I know pretty well. A lot of them don't want to do it. They, as soon as you talk computers to a lot of the guys, they just go backwards. They don't want nothing to do with it, which, and I kept telling them, you've got to start learning because you're going to end up getting left behind.
My name's Tracy Beer and I'm the manager of short adult community education courses at Polytechnic West.
Do a double click on the left button now.
We provide adult community education as opposed to the accredited training, which leads to a qualification. We place great value in the adult community education programs that it can lead people into that further education or definitely can lead them to employment.
Now, what happened is that you have now created a footer.
We find a lot of students can see adult community education as almost a try before you buy, so they can try a course in a non-threatening social environment where there's no assessments and there's less pressure.
The A student, adult community services education students, they are a lot more mature. They know what they want.
Modern technology, everything involves computer. You know.
There's computers and everything.
When they come in, you see them turning on the computer by themselves, start using the computer on their own. That is really, really good. I'm actually very, very thankful for having this opportunity to teach in the ACE course itself.
I've got a new job through my computer skills. So, I'm really happy.
Oh, it's good. I like it. Every time I learn something new, I thought, oh, yeah, great, you know.
Hopefully I can learn more and take further courses, you know, that improve my skills better.
That's page 2 of 2. One more time. 3 of 3. Yep, good.
To find more information or to locate an adult community education provider in your local area, call 1300 iLearn, 1300 453 276. Or you can explore the following websites: adultlearnersweek.org, acetv.com.au. Alternatively, you can visit your local community centre, TAFE, or local library, and find out what's going on in your local community.